7 days.
All right, Paul, thank you. The Hamilton County Commission's new policy for opening meetings with prayer has added a complaint for those suing to stop it. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Gordon Boyd tells us about the protests that got two people escorted out.
Cindy, Commission Chairman Larry Henry says one man shouldn't have been, but it came after a pastor, the first to accept the commission's invitation to lead prayer, closed by invoking Jesus. Of the 548 invitations mailed last week, only 7 congregations aren't Christian. 4 are Jewish, 1 Muslim. So far, no non-Christian has replied.
1 week later, this is still propaganda.
One of those suing, Tommy Coleman, spends about 2 minutes telling Hamilton County Commissioners why he believes a moment of silence is constitutional and their new prayer policy still isn't. But Aaron Moyer is who draws the ire.
The Hamilton County Commission is a den of vipers.
After 4.5 minutes in which he quotes a Christian friend calling commissioners unchristlike.
Sir, we've got 2 more speakers and we've got about 3 minutes left on this subject.
I'm almost done.
It didn't have anything to do with the content of his speech.
Rather, Chairman Larry Henry says commissioners limit public comment to 10 minutes per subject, but Moyer keeps talking another minute and a half.
I'm going to ask that you sit down now, please.
There are names for people like that. Whitewash sepulchers.
Sit down, turn it off.
At least that's what Christ called them. Whitewash sepulchers and a den of vipers.
I'm going to ask security, if you would, to escort this gentleman.
The commission's deputy asks Moyer and Coleman to leave. Both do, but...
I didn't ask Tommy Coleman to be moved.
Off camera, the deputy tells me she believed Henry wanted both men removed, which he denies.
The deputy kind of took it upon herself to ask Mr. Coleman to leave as well?
Right.
And that was totally her?
That was totally her.
Coleman's lawyer says, regardless of who did it.
We'll have to look at it and amend the complaint to add a Fourth Amendment violation for an unreasonable seizure.
If the root of all this is about time, the answer still isn't clear as to how the commission keeps it and who gets what. Together, Coleman and Moyer take up 8 3/4 of the 10 minutes allotted for prayer comment.
Yeah, I'll make it brief.
The last speaker, Pastor Charles Wysong, takes another 2 1/4, after commissioners give activist June Griffin only a minute, prompting her to give Coleman and Moyer the figurative riot act.
And you're going to jail. Title 18 requires jail sentence and $10,000 for intimidating or harassing anybody for the exercise of their rights, including the 9th and 10th Amendment.
Ms. Griffin is trying to join the federal lawsuit, arguing that the 9th and 10th Amendment gives the commission the power to set rules for prayer. A judge will hear motions to stop the prayers in a couple of weeks. Live in studio, Gordon Boyd, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Thanks, Gordon.